Thank you very much, Ken. And good afternoon, everyone. Our project at Cornell is less than a year old, but we've made a lot of progress. We are trying to bring real-time experiential design to urban design and city making. As you know, the urban design process basically has two parts to it. There are the space-making players who consist of architects, planners, engineers, who make the buildings, the roads, infrastructure, the landscape architects do all the landscape. And then there is a place-making team that tries to use visualization, narratives, and other means to create spatial experiences that would be enjoyed by the users of the city. Those two parts form a paradigm, and those two paradigms are really quite separate from each other. Each paradigm has developed its own history, content, and workflows. The space-making paradigm generally involves digital systems that make these urban spaces. And the place-making ones are actually focused on how we experience the city and how we navigate the city, the types of narratives that we create when we move through cities. Typically, the space makers dominate the process. But in actual fact, cities like architecture are experienced. So our job at Cornell is to try to bring the two together. These are the two paradigms, and this is the way in which they relate right now. You have the abstractions and the concepts, and then you have the visualization. We think the two have to come in some sort of symbiotic relationship with each other, and also inform the process as we move through with the design of the city. And we talk a lot about, big data. I mean, if you are designing whole cities, or even portions of cities, you are dealing with massive amounts of information. So trying to bring these things together is quite a challenge. And we want to do it not by importing works from DCC software into Unreal, but actually working in tandem with Unreal. So previously, we've done this using gaming engines in an immersive cave at Cornell. But lately, we've realized that Unreal Engine has so much more power that we can move it beyond the cave and use much more distributed systems of immersion in virtual reality. So what we've done is look for two things. The first is a platform that is capable of doing the space making in urban design. And we've settled on City Engine as a very powerful system that can do the job. And then we also looked for a very powerful platform that can do the real-time experiential work, which naturally is Unreal Engine. I think it's totally unsurpassed in terms of its capabilities. And then we put a team together to develop an interface between the two. The team comprises faculty at Cornell, students, graduates, and upper-class students, and also industry partners. We have partners from FX Collaborative, KPF, HOK, SHOP, and we all work together to try to define the types of flows that we want and also the tools that we'll need to do this project. So I'm going to play you a little video clip, short one, in which the partners discuss what they are doing. And then I will play you two clips of what we are actually doing with this software.
One of the exciting things about this project for us is working with both a leading academic institution in Cornell and Epic, one of the leaders in virtual reality technology, to really be on the forefront of developing workflows and technology that'll impact both academia and the industry. There's a disconnect between how we design and how we represent it. And virtual reality has been a way to always better represent what we've designed, but we have yet to actually design in this. So this is solving a disconnect between the abstraction and the representation.
In the VR environment, we're really hoping that these new sets of tools will allow us to collaboratively be in that environment together, make those changes, and in real time understand what those design moves experientially feel like, therefore accelerating the decision-making process. The first iteration of this tool is looking at bringing in parametric buildings from Esri into the Unreal Engine that you can collaboratively adjust and in real time understand what those changes in the urban environment will feel like.
The research that we do in the lab focus on environmental modeling tools such as outdoor comfort, indoor comfort, energy use in buildings, daylighting in buildings. And in connection with VR, we can bring the data that these tools produce into an environment that can be experienced by the designer, but also by the potential clients or the potential urban dwellers. And getting that kind of feedback loop together, I think, is really critical to designing these kinds of urban environments.
With VR, we're able to reconnect the hand, the mind, and the eye, but within a three-dimensional space. We're no longer dealing with that interface of the screen and the interface of the keyboard, but actually able to directly interact with a particular environment through the hands.
The students are really excited. They're curious to kind of explore the technology and its potentials. I think they clearly understand that this dramatically changes the way we design. And finally, they have everything together in one place to explore kind of where the boundaries are and how we can develop them further.
Yeah, so those are the partners working in team. Next, we've started a studio in which we are looking at using these tools to design the city, but from the bottoms up. Normally, city design is done with master planning from the top down. We are starting from the bottoms up because that is the way in which cities really get experienced. So the two clips you'll be seeing are designs of existing streets. They took almost, I would say, about 4 hours to do each one. And the students have actually modeled the streets, walked through them, brought them into twin motion, added entourage and all the pizzazz to make the placemaking, and then gone in and are now modifying the designs. So let's take a look at the first one. It's in Vienna. The idea behind this is that cities start with links and places. Links are streets, places are your plazas and public spaces. So this is an example of a modeling process. And they are able to do this very quickly. That's the whole idea. You don't spend days and weeks on them. You do them in an afternoon. And the next one is a street in the ocean front of Boston. Again, modeling the existing and then making some interventions to change the buildings, to change the streets, to change the entourage and make it as realistic as possible. So these are works in progress. We are going to spend some time, another couple of weeks on these, and then we'll put them together and create larger and larger urban settings. The students who create the most believable streets will get flown over to go and experience those streets and actually test their models with the real stuff and see how they correspond to each other. So we've received a lot of support, and these are some of the supporters of the project. So thank you very much. You are all welcome to communicate with us, and we'll keep you abreast of our progress.
Thank you. Excellent. Thank you very much.